Richie. Just received one. A power play, 16th. 20.6%. Montreal ninth best when it comes to penalty killing. Here's Seeling in front, but his shot deflected off Lawler. And Lawler, number 38, now controlling for Montreal, makes a good play off the boards to get it by Vernon, and the Sabres have to go back. Number 5 is Mike Ramsey on this Buffalo power play. Broken up. Chance on the breakaway by Carboneau. Big save, Luce. And then the rebound is taken over by Hanno Virta. Big save there by Luce on Carboneau on a breakaway. Here comes Seeley. Into the corner against Green. Clearing it to John Tucker. Back to Mike Ramsey. Carboneau trying to get it out. He couldn't, neither could Lawler. Now Lawler and Tucker battle for it. Comes to the point. Ramsey to the other point. Berta with a drive just wide. And Guy Carboneau then poked at the center ice. Big save there by Kluche to ward off Carboneau.
Carboneau's playing pretty well. Don't forget he had that save when Robinson messed up in front of his own net. He's very effective so far.
Puck put in by Buffalo there on the power play, but Green is there, and he played it high off the glass. All the way down the ice. 23 seconds left in Richer's penalty. And here is the veteran Gilbert Perreault. He could be playing his last game at Memorial Auditorium. Speculation is he may retire. Here is Perreault moving in, centered. The Smithy goal! But they ain't dead yet, Mr. Roos.
Well, they want to list. See, if you're going to have a memory of Gilbert Perreault, how about that little effort? He'll get the assist on it. It was all Gilbert Perreault. All really we needed from Doug Smith was the tap-in. He fought off the check from Ludwig, slid the puck over to Smith. Boy, what an effort. And it's 1-0.
Doug Smith's 18th of the year. He had 8 goals with Los Angeles. In 48 games, this is his 10th in 29 games with Buffalo. John Tucker trying to flip it through, does a back end, and they score! And Tuck, and it's 2-0 for the Sabres.
Bobby, it looked like everybody just quit on this play. Here's Tucker coming over. Now he makes the move and slides it to the wing. And in comes Andrejczyk, right around Svoboda. And just all of a sudden, people seem to stop.
So often you hear that comment about play away from the puck, and I think the Canadians were guilty of watching that puck carrier too much that he was able to sneak in behind there. He really wasn't picked up by Svoboda until it was too late, and Andrejczyk, of course, is deadly when he gets around that net.
Well, he just
Canadians trying to move it out of there, dropping it back to Chelios. Over to Ludwig. Back to Chris Chelios. He's checked, and here's Perreault. Rink wide to Foligno. Shoots, he scores! Mike Foligno, and it's 3-0 for the Sabres.
I don't know whether that shot was tipped. It wound up going between Doug Sautard's legs. Perreault right across the ice. Foligno just wound up. And I think it must have gone off the stick of the defenseman moving up on the play. Here it is, as what is that? Ludwig, I think, that was moving over to make the check.
That's the first shot, by the way, Buffalo's had on goal in this period.
41 goals for Mike Foligno. He's done everything with this team. He's got the best plus minus on the team by far among the forwards. He's got well over 20. He's scored the goals for him. He's done the checking for them. Clearly the most valuable player they've had through the whole season.
Playoffs beginning Wednesday for the Canadians against Boston. Roy, I take it, will be the starter.
Oh, I'm not so sure about that.
Oh, I thought you came up with the starting lineup.
Goaltending has been a very much discussed part of the game this year.
Wasn't Penny a little bit injured right now?
He is. It'll be between Roy and Doug Sautard, but if I were betting, I'd think Sautard.
Here's Berta at the point, a shot, they score! John Tucker deflecting it in. And it's 4-0 for the Buffalo Sabres.
touch for Tucker around the net. They always talk about Tucker's ability around the net. Here it is, and he, not only that, he had to take the deflection up near his skates. He had to shorten up on that stick, and then he got a good deflection away on the Virta shot from the point. Here it comes. Watch, right in front. He just kind of scooped it like a little shovel, and he scooped it right by Patrick Roy. And now it is 4-0.
And John Tucker gets his 31st of the year.